How much longer?
10 more seconds. Concentrate.
This is so stupid.
It's not stupid. You're gonna love it.
Levitation. It's the ultimate high.
Right. Into position.
And up she goes!
Whoa! Whoa! Oh my God, we've made her fly!
Put me down! Put me down!
Maguire, we must only use this power for good.
Oh. Nah, it's just a trick, man. But it's cool, isn't it?
Fantastic!
Eric, give me my drink. I'm extremely dehydrated.
There we go. One orange squash.
Eric, I told you my top three choices were Fanta, Tab or Cherryade.
Nevertheless, one orange squash.
I'll just have water. There's a hose in the garden.
Eric, I've noticed the pop selection has really gone down since your dad got fired.
He didn't get fired. He's part-time. And shut up.
Eric, listen. The prince is coming to Luton.
What prince?
Prince Charles, the Prince of Wales, the Earl of Cornwall, the Duke of wherever. Anyway, he's coming to Luton.
Why would Prince Charles come to Luton?
Oh, he's opening something or other. There's a reception for him at the college. Daddy organised it.
Dear, the next time you know a member of our royal family is visiting, could you give me just a little bit more notice? Oh, my life, I haven't dusted in weeks. I've got to polish all the furniture. Eric, tidy up this garage.
She's not actually coming to our house.
You never know.
Out in the hole again.
Yes, well, why don't we miss a mortgage repayment? Then we could all eat steak. Just imagine. The Prince of Wales is visiting. Ronnie, you must clip that privet.
Well, it's not like he's visiting our house.
No, that's what I said. Never mind.
Why is he coming anyway?
I think he's opening a new assembly line. At the factory.
Oh, well, that's just great. That really takes the biscuit. I lose half my job to a machine and the Queen's jug-eared son comes along. Gives it the royal seal of approval. Rule bloody Britannia.
Sweetheart, it's not as if the prince took your job. And it's good that his ears are so wide, because it'll make it easier for him to listen to his people when he becomes our ruler.
Yeah. It'll make it easier to lift his head out the executioner's basket.
Nevertheless, he is our future king.
Oh, for God's sake, the lad's old enough to know what a load of old crap the royal family is. Listen, Eric, just because a bunch of interbred Germans swan around England like they own this place doesn't mean that we should lick their boots. Remember that.
And perhaps Eric should also remember that there has been a king or queen on the throne for quite some time, and it would be rather rude to ask them to leave it now.
What do you think, Eric?
Well, I suppose that I would have to say that everyone's political opinions are both valid and worth hearing. On the one hand, you are right. And so is Mum.
That's just great, son. So when you vote for the first time, you'll be able to tick all the little boxes.
Firstly, a note for those who've been making deliveries to the old folks' home. Coal is not, I repeat, not a vegetable. Now, I've called this special assembly because, as you probably all know, Luton will soon be honoured by a visit from His Royal Highness, the Prince of Wales. This will be a great occasion for the town and a great day for everyone. But I fear there could be some rotten apples who will try to spoil our barrel of fun. And even though we are...
Who cares if Prince Charles is coming?
Well, at least it's better than when the Radio 1 roadshow came.
Oh, yeah, Leo Sayre and a free pencil case signed by Diddy David Hamilton.
Yeah, I was hoping for at least that chick from the Top of the Pops album cover.
And yes, even Cleethorpes. So let me spell it out, Mr. or Mrs. Troublemaker. This is not an opportunity for some sort of quote-unquote social statement type of protest. It may seem a chance to prove your manhood or prove that you're cool, but this is our future king, the son of our queen, so please, no idiotic attempts to get attention. And no shenanigans. Otherwise, you might just as well go home right now.
So, the prince and party should be arriving around noon. He won't have a very large entourage.
Oh, curried eggs. Are these for anybody?
Hi, Daddy. Hi, Mr. Palmer.
Hello, kitten. Us grown-ups are talking about grown-up things here. Why don't you and your friend go up to your room? Now, I'm delighted to inform you that the board of the car plant and some other captains of industry will be coming along to the reception.
Obviously, they're not real captains, so there's no need to salute. Back to you, Jeff.
Now, normally at the reception, a local dignitary, such as myself, would thank the prince for his attendance, but considering the controversy over the assembly line, the people at the car plant thought it might be a good gesture if it was made by one of their own employees. Working class, factory floor type chap. The man on the Clapham omnibus. I suppose someone you and I would term a pleb.
So, of course, I thought of you. We'd like you to thank the Prince of Wales. So what do you say to that?
I say no thank you and I want my mole grips back.
I'll do it.
That's very sweet of you, Kitty, but we're looking for someone who will be able to hold the floor. You know, a man. But just imagine, Ron, the top brass from your firm, the people who own your factory, will be there, and you, the average bloke on the shop floor, will be talking to the Prince of Wales, our future head of state, in front of them. Take advantage of the opportunity.
Turn that light off.
Sorry.
We need to do something subversive. Something that says we won't bow down to the meaningless figureheads of a corrupt system.
I know. A well-conducted referendum.
That's good.
Yeah.
I just think Dylan's looking for something a little easier to arrange before Tuesday tour.
Yeah. Something in the radical tradition of Cromwell and Guy Fawkes.
Yeah. I know. Let's streak.
Bingo!
I mean, we could run naked as the day we were born for a whole sea of people. I've always wanted to do that. You know, just be free and shake it about. So, who's with me?
Will people be chasing us through ice and snow with pointy sticks?
No.
Then I'm in.
Cool.
Eric?
Streaking?
Yeah.
Listen, don't get me wrong. I'm completely pro-nudity. But I think my dad would kill me, and I'm kind of anti being killed.
There wasn't a huge downside to doing something this stupid. Wouldn't be worth doing.
Oh, good point.
Hey, Donna,
what about you?
Well, completely humiliate myself in front of everybody I know and the next King of England, that's quite an offer.
Yeah. Suit yourself, but you're missing out on a chance to really make a statement. Yeah. I think I'm going to write a top slogan, like, I hate the filth on my arse!
you hate the filth on your ass, why don't you just wash it off?
Pretty snazzy, huh?
Patriotically groovy, Dad.
You like it? I've got one for you, too.
We're going to wear them at the reception.
No. No way!
Sweetie, please, this is really important to me. Mr. Burgett and all the other businessmen are doing something. I want to be involved too. I'll get your outfit. You can try it on.
No, Dad! Mum, why are you doing this?
Donna, there are a lot of things I have to do to keep your father happy that I don't really like.
Mum?
Oh, no, not that! No, I love that. No, no, what I meant was, like, watching Match of the Day.
And look, honey, you're right in the middle. You're the centre of the whole flag.
It'll be wonderful. Everyone will be looking at us.
Exactly. Look, I've already turned down one good offer to make a fool of myself. Sorry.
Oh, but Donna, please, do it for me. Do it for the family.
No.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear, oh, dear. Hello.
Good news, Bob. I've had a think about it, and I've decided I would like to give the thanks to Prince Charles.
Blimey, Ron, that is good news. Well, it's good to see that some people are still prepared to stand up and be counted as patriots.
Yeah, well, glad I could help. Oh, I'll give thanks, all right.
Ron.
Don't worry. I'm just going to take this opportunity to tell it like it is. Especially when the Ponce of Wales is listening.
Ronnie, please don't call him that. He's sensitive. He paints. He talks to plants.
Well, he'll regret the day he came to talk to ours, won't he?
My goodness. This food was so cheap. Oh, I see.
So, Eric, the reception's tomorrow. What's the decision?
Yeah, you're gonna streak or not?
Maybe Eric doesn't want to look stupid.
Look, if we all look stupid together, we'll look cool.
Maybe he's not got the equipment for the job.
Well, I've been doing some thinking and, I'm in.
Yes.
Well, I have to say, you're gonna look like a gang of idiots.
That's right, a gang of naked idiots.
Maguire, pipe down. This has to stay between us. We can't let anybody find out what we have planned.
Right. Oh, they'll all just want to join in.
No, because if my father finds out, he'll nail me to a tree.
Why are you all sitting on one side of the table, huh?
See, Eric? I've got a coronation vessel for everybody after Queen Victoria. Except for Edward VIII, of course. He never got crowned because he married Mrs. Simpson, the American prostitute. I got given this one when King George VI was crowned. You'll probably get one next year for the Silver Jubilee.
Well, so they get sovereignty over the nation for 1,000 years and, we get mugs.
The red flag flying.
Oh, Dada, Bob Plummer wanted me to pass this on to you.
What is it?
It's the approved wording for the thanks to Prince Charles.
The approved wording for the thanks?
Yes.
What do you mean they don't think I can say thanks, Prince Charles, without getting me tongue tangled?
Oh, Ronnie, don't be stupid. There are probably special royal ways of saying these things. You've probably got to say, thank you, and may Lord smite the Catholics, or something like that.
Well, let's have a look. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to thank His Royal Highness the Prince of Wales for his presence here today. May I wish him good health, and here's to a swift smiting of the Catholics. Oh, you're right. Joke.
Don't joke. He'll be king one day.
Well, I'll say any bloody thing I like. I'm no organ grinder's monkey.
Dad, I was wondering, could I borrow your raincoat?
It's not often you get the ear of the bigwigs who sold you down the river.
I'll take good care of it. I'll bring it back right away.
A man is not a plaything to be picked up and discarded like a used rag.
Sweetheart, just take the coat and leave.
I refuse to stand idly by while everything is taken from me.
Fine, I'll borrow another coat.
No, take the coat, take it. I'm talking about a man's self-respect, his ability to put food on the table and coal on the fire. If they take that, what's left?
You've still got the Toyota, darling. It's very economical.
What, dear God, is left?
Can I just say I really hate being in this room right now?
Me too.
At least I've still got my family.
Where are you?
Okay. Okay. So when they finish the welcome speeches, we let rip and shake the snakes!
Oh, this is gonna be so cool, man. You know we're gonna be the legends of Luton.
Did you write, I hate the filth on your ass?
Yep. Oh, yeah. Cheers, Donna. Here's your lipstick.
You can keep it.
Got the masks?
Yeah, I got two Marilyn Monroes, Harold Wilson, and the Queen.
You know, that'd make a great porno.
Bagsy, not the Queen!
Wait, Bagsy.
Yeah, Bagsy.
Oh, well, so I get the Queen?
You'll get extra respect.
Tor?
Yeah?
How do you know about Bagsy?
Oh, my people invented Bagsy.
Well, can we go yet? I'm dying to unveil the monument.
Well, that Mr. Columbo has made quite an impression, hasn't he?
Okay, let's go!
Let's go!
Aren't you going, Donna?
No. My mum and dad are going and they want me to wear this really square jumpsuit and I can't do it. It's just too embarrassing.
You know, Donna, when I was little, I used to have an uncle. Funny Uncle Brian, we used to call him. But he wasn't funny in a good way. No. You see, Uncle Brian had lost his hearing during the war, so you really had to speak up when you spoke to him. He always used to come round when me and my friends were listening to the wireless, and I found him really embarrassing. So this one time, I pretended that we weren't in, when we were, because I didn't want my friends to see him. Then 16 years later, he dropped stone cold dead from a bad pint, apparently. A very bad pint. So you see?
No.
Families are embarrassing, and if they're not embarrassing, they're dead.
Right, guys, just play it cool. Try and blend it.
Oi! Are you chatting my girlfriend or chewing a brick?
Michael, he's not.
Why?
Because either way, I'm going to beat you up.
Yeah?
Yeah!
Yeah?
Yeah!
Come on! No, come on!
Listen, you're so lucky I'm completely naked, pal.
Been thinking, and if you want to embarrass the prince in front of your bosses, it's all right by me. As your wife, I should encourage you to express your feelings. In fact, I've been doing some calculations, and with the help of our savings, we could survive on the dole for almost a year before we fall below the official poverty line.
Kitty, stop it.
I have to go to the loo.
There's another man in a raincoat.
You were right. Now everyone wants a streak.
No, I think he may be a special branch.
Well, there are pigs everywhere.
Those pigs look like dogs. Well, the little friendly dog is looking at us.
Listen, something's just occurred to me. I mean, we're naked.
Yeah.
There are a lot of dogs here. Maybe we should all sit down.
Right.
I'm out.
Me too.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll meet you guys later. Oh, I don't know what you're doing here.
So, are you going to streak?
Well, we took a vote, and it's unanimous. We're all chickens.
That's a shame. I was really looking forward to distraction from the Palmer Family Flag Day. Besides, it's been ages since I've seen you naked.
Well, you've never seen me naked.
Eric, I've seen you naked about a million times. When we were kids, you used to run up the road screaming, wee wee pee pee.
Let's talk about your doctor and nurses in the sandpit.
Okay, quits.
I'd like now to ask Mr. Ron Foreman, an employee at the local car factory, to stand and give thanks to His Royal Highness on behalf of the people of Luton for his visit here today. Ron.
Thank you. Yes. I've got something very important that I've got to say.
Come on, Ron. Your dad is freaking out.
I must say, we did know you were coming here today, but we didn't expect to see the crown jewels as well.
Hello there, son.
Hi, Dad. You, did a good job at the reception today.
Yeah, well, I sort of stumbled at the beginning, but I don't think the Prince will forget me in a hurry.
Yeah, pretty cool. Anyway, I'm going to call it a night.
All right then, son. All night.
Good night, Dad.
By the way, next time, take your socks off too. You look like a complete pillock.
So, the Queen. Who'd have thought she looked like that underneath, eh?
Yeah, what a dark horse.
So how come they didn't catch you?
I don't think anybody wanted to tackle a naked man.
Yeah, understandable.
You didn't see anything, did you?
No. Nothing. Maybe just a little bit.
Good. Hold on, what do you mean a little bit?